The point was I had to come up with $7,000.
Imagine getting a phone call claiming that someone from your family was sitting in jail and desperately needed money to bail out of there. Well, that's what happened to a Lehigh Acres man, but it turns out it was all a scam.
NBC2's Joanna Boris is live in our control room after talking with that victim and an expert about how you can prevent this from happening.
The victim says all he wanted to do is help out his granddaughter-in-law, but it was that impulsive thinking that cost him $7,000. Howard Breeze says he got a phone call early Thursday morning from someone pretending to be his granddaughter-in-law.
She told me she'd been in a car accident. She was driving somebody else's car.
The caller says she was driving her friend home from having cataract surgery when she rear-ended another car, injuring a little girl in the back seat.
Which actually made sense, I guess.
And now she claims she needed money for bail.
The point was I had to come up with $7,000.
Bree says the caller wouldn't let him talk to his supposed granddaughter-in-law after the first call because of a gag order. And if he didn't act quickly, she'd have to sit in jail overnight.
I was just paying attention. It was my granddaughter, and I wanted to get her out of trouble.
So he sent $7,000 in cash to Pennsylvania.
The following day, I think it was late in the morning, early afternoon, I called my granddaughter and she was home. Nothing had happened.
Which is when he realized he'd been played.
I should have caught on. I didn't. My fault.
An identity theft expert says this particular scam is extremely common, and it's easy for scammers to find out information about their victims.
Here in Florida, we have very, very, very open public record laws. You can go online to any clerk of courts, property appraiser's website, and you can look up pretty much everything and anything about anyone you want.
Breeze says he called the police, but was told the odds are slim that the scammers will be caught and his money returned.
What a sucker I had been. $7,000, bye-bye.
Kursky says to protect your family from scams, come up with a code word. That way when scammers call, you can ask for that word. If they don't know it, you'll know something's not right. Live in the control room, Joanna Boris, NBC2.